Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com and welcome back to the channel and welcome to this new tutorial on how to create a debug visual view, of course, all of it in Swift 5. So without further ado, let's jump right into it. Okay, now if you have been tinkering out with SwiftUI, you will see that we have these kind of borders for these elements when you are highlighting the row in the code. So this is not quite a good example because we are accessing all of these inspector variables for this label. But if you have been taking a look at the Swift UI interface, you will see that if you highlight or just basically grab, add your cursor to a new line of code, it will be highlighted in this new preview panel. I believe it's called a canvas. Okay, so we want to do that right now with UIKit. So let's jump right into the code and go ahead and click the link down below so you can see all of the resources. And what I have basically added here is it's not too much. I have added tiny constraints so we can better constrain our label here. Added the label, set the view's background color to white, added some text to our label, added this label to our view and centered it into our super view. And yeah, let's just build and run and see how that looks. And as you can see here, I've already started some basic stuff for our debug UI view. So there we go. But at this time, we don't really know all of the, let's so-called borders of our label. So yeah, let's just create a debug view so we can see if it's here or somewhere else. Okay, and this will be for a UI label, but I'm going to create an extension for a UI view because basically a UI label is a UI view. And yeah, a lot of elements are based off a UI view. So you can later down the line use this, let's say to your UI text field or UI text view and so on. So what I basically added here is this public function called debug, and it is returning a UI view. Now, if you don't know what the discardable result means, go ahead and take a look at one of my previous videos. I have just recently released a brand, well, awesome video on what this discardable result really means. Okay, so for now, let us just tackle the debug view. So what we want to add in here is basically add some borders. So we are in a UI view, so we are going to grab our label and we are going to add a border color, and that is, let's say, my blue, and of course this is a CG color. Okay, and layer dot border width, let's have this only to 1 pixel. So what we want to do now is basically add this function to our label, and I'm just going to comment this out. After we add some text to it, we are setting this debug here. Okay, and that is basically it. Well, we could maybe add this to 1.5. There we go, let's hit Command R and see this in action. And yeah, much better. So while we are at it, let me just make this a little fancier because yeah, it kind of looks like this one, but I don't want to be exactly the same. So let me just add some background color too. So background color equals my blue, and I will set an alpha component of 0.3 and set some border corner radius. So layer dot corner radius equals, let's say, 3, and for that we want to set the layers masks to bounce to true. There we go. Okay, and let's build and run and see how that looks like. Okay, real good. Now, this is quite usual to see, and you most probably knew that, okay, the bounds would be somewhere here, but what if we set some left and right constraints to our label here? And let's just build and run and see how this looks like, and we'll see that basically we have all of this label laid out here. And if we get rid of the debug, we don't really know where it starts and where it ends. Of course, if you take a look at the code, but yeah, I don't know if it's starting here or where it is ending, or maybe it's starting here, who knows. But with the new debug extension that we have just created, we can see it straight away. Okay. Now, this debug extension is part of a DocUI. Go ahead and take a look at it. And of course, you could create UI labels, separate extensions, but most probably UI view will fit everything that you need. And of course, here we have our UI stack views too, and much, much more inside DocUI. If you are interested in it, go ahead and take a look at my GitHub repository and just download it, or maybe use it with CocoaPods. You can install it with CocoaPods. So yeah, go ahead and take a look at it. DocUI, it's SwiftUI for UIKit, well, kind of. And I really hope that you enjoyed this Visual Debug UI View for UIKit video tutorial. If you did, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to the channel and hit that notification bell to get notified of new videos as they do come out. Now it is your turn. How do you really debug your views in Xcode? Go ahead and leave your comments down below. And as usual, I will see you in the next one.